Tonight, it's a two-city stop. The search for the next American Idol takes us to the home of rock and roll, Cleveland. And to the vacation destination, Orlando. Let's do it. Back in 1952, about the time Simon was a teenager, a guy by the name of Alan Freed, a DJ like myself, coined the term rock and roll to describe the new R&B sounds that were exploding at the time. So is the heart of rock and roll still beating in Cleveland? There's only one way to find out. Brown Stadium played host to 15,000 contestants in the home of rock and roll. It started out as a beautiful day with record numbers for Idol. But then it was record rainfall for Cleveland as storm clouds emptied with a vengeance.
Cleveland is crappy weather.
It's raining right now, they're gonna make us go inside.
And the solution was to sweat it out in the tunnels.
They got a hotel in St. Louis, they're getting one in D.C., but we get a stadium. It's a conspiracy.
But when the sun began to shine, so did the auditioners. Damp but determined, ready for the judges.
Cleveland.
Including guest judge, hip-hop legend LL Cool J.
Gonna find the next American Idol.
As one of the founding fathers of hip-hop, LL Cool J has carved out a prolific career with six straight multi-platinum albums and a string of knockout hits. With his charm and charisma, this two-time Grammy Award winner's career has even led him to Hollywood, where he's appeared in over 17 films. But would this multimedia powerhouse be sending any of our Cleveland contestants back to Cali?
Are you gonna be nice?
Nicer than you.
One of the first from the thousands in Cleveland was an emotional Jacqueline Crum, who was in tears even before she auditioned.
Hi, Jacqueline. How are you doing?
Good. It's so nice to meet you. I love you.
Thank you very much. Oh. It's a pleasure to meet you.
What do you like about her?
Well, I like how she sings and she's pretty, and I grew up listening to her.
Oh, that's good.
That's cool.
Thank you, honey.
That's sweet.
Whenever you're ready.
Okay. Some people search for the fountain. The promise is forever young. And some people need 36 roses. And it's the only way to prove you love them.
Thank you. You have potentially quite a good voice.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Your problem is that you've had absolutely no experience in performing.
And you look scared to death.
Unbelievable voice.
Just needs work and more experience with it.
I like this girl's voice, and I would like to think that something wonderful could happen in 2 or 3 months, but I'm really doubtful.
I mean, you think about Josh Stone, you think about different people that are out there. You got to start somewhere, and I think that she's good enough to continue on and start here and make this her beginning.
So, Ella, what are you saying, yes or no?
I'm saying yes.
Okay, Randy?
I don't think you're ready yet, me personally.
Okay, so it's a no.
Nothing would make me happier for you to prove him wrong, so I say yes.
Jacqueline, we are going to see you in Hollywood. You've made it through to the next
round.
Yay!
Thank you very much.
Yay!
As well as Jacqueline's family, nearby with a hug was our next contestant, Sarah Sue Kelly.
Good job. I'll talk to you later.
I am 18 years old. I've been singing since the age of 5, ever since I can remember. And I just love doing it. It's my passion.
Hello.
Hi, Sarah.
Hi.
How are you, darling?
I am great.
Are you happy to be here?
I am very happy to be here.
Okay. What do you do, Sarah?
I'm going to be a student at ISU, Indiana State University. And I have my own karaoke business, Sunflower Sue's Karaoke.
So do you sing at the karaoke?
Oh, yeah, I own it, I operate it, I sing.
Okay.
Oh, cool.
What are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing, it's from My Fair Lady, I Could Have Danced All Night.
Fabulous.
I could have danced all night, I could have danced all night, and still have begged for more. I could have spread
spread my wings and done a thousand things I've never done before. I never knew it made it so exciting. Why, all at once my heart took flight. I only know when he began to dance with me, I could have danced, danced, danced all night.
Okay.
Ooh, pretty.
LL.
You're a funny guy, man.
You know what's cool? Honestly, I felt like when you were singing, like you had a secret.
Really?
Yeah, like it was like everything you sung, I felt like you would, like you had a secret, and I thought that that was cute. I'm on the fence.
Well, I'm not on the fence. I say no, but the My Fair Lady, you know, maybe you should follow that road.
Okay.
That was good.
Do you like doing that on stage?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I love theater.
Yeah.
Sarah, I mean, if I'm being honest.
Go ahead.
Honest.
Yeah, that's fine.
It's the way you look that's putting us off.
Oh, come on.
I mean, that's okay.
It's true.
I'm here just to show that I don't have to be a Barbie to be an American Idol.
No, you don't have to be a Barbie, but I'm just going to
give what you just said.
A reality check, Sarah, because I think
this is reality.
No, but I think you have a nice voice.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And I think this is a business, Sarah, where I'm not going to lie to you, where people will judge you based on the way you look.
Yeah.
That's true.
Yeah, there's nothing new.
Unfortunately.
But yeah, that needs to change.
I'm not saying that I'm like that. But people are.
Oh my.
But you know what else? I know he's a pretty boy.
A reality
check.
You know,
he's a pretty boy.
We know he's
a pretty boy.
Sarah, if you believe
I like
that.
You.
No, I mean.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Don't believe him, Sarah.
I think we are all in agreement. You have a good voice.
Alrighty.
I'm going to say no. I didn't say what I said to be horrible. I said
it to be kind. Yeah.
Because it's that kind of business.
Mm-hmm. I understand.
Thank you.
And you know what? You stay focused. And I love that Barbie comment.
I'll be back.
All right, much love to you, all right?
Yeah, come back, you're young, come back.
Kisses and hugs to you. I love that Barbie comment, that was great.
Oh, thank you.
Barbie's people, too.
Thank you.
I love
you.
That, all right.
Well, no ticket to Hollywood.
It was good, though.
But at least she got some good loving from LL. Not a bad day for Sarah Sue. Welcome back to American Idol. The hunt continues in Cleveland. And it was a familiar sight. Dejected faces emerging from the room. Judges looking bored. For those guys, Cleveland didn't rock. It sucked.
You shine so bright. For 5 long years, I thought you were my man. Yeah. I'm sorry.
I'm gonna hold you. I want you inside of these arms.
Dude, you shouldn't ever be singing. It's not for you, man. That was horrific, man. Come on.
Some people want diamond rings. Some just want everything. But everything means nothing if I ain't got you.
Next.
Kaya wa nu yu me o long, long time. Hayato mishi mai kole. Prima deli, it's on my way. Kagili nakizuyu huwe.
I think you've been reincarnated.
No, come on.
I do. I think you've been reincarnated.
Oh, is that right?
And we'll share tomorrow together.
Well, that sounds like a hit.
The home of rock and roll was turning into the mistake by the lake. Why, oh, why did we come to Cleveland? But then, around the corner came Scott Savel.
American Idol, Cleveland 2004. Cleveland,
he knew he was what Cleveland we needed.
Man, I'm about to go in there and just rip. I'm gonna give them everything I got. They want 100%, I'm giving them 150.
Yeah, hopefully the judges would like him as much as he liked them.
First, I wanna say, I've loved watching your show. Randy, you the coolest dude on TV.
Thank you, baby.
Harley, you the most beautiful woman on TV.
Well, thank you very much.
Simon, regardless of what anyone says about you, I don't care what they say, you're still cool in my book. LL, my dude.
That was good sucking up, that stuff.
Oh, hey.
Okay, it says here that your dad has no confidence in you.
That's his problem.
Tell me.
I mean, my dad has
I've grown up with my dad telling me I wasn't gonna be anything, and I guess it was because he wasn't able to accomplish much, so I guess he figured I was gonna follow his footsteps, and that's not the truth.
Okay, so you're gonna prove him wrong.
I'm my own man.
Okay, good for you, Scott.
That's good.
And why are you here?
I'm here to become the next American Idol.
What have you got?
I've got the voice, I got the look, I got the confidence, I've got the personality.
Well, I'm gonna give you 3 out of 4 on that. Okay, what are you gonna sing?
I'm gonna sing Superstar.
Okay, off you go.
Don't you remember you told me you love me, baby? You said you'd be coming back this way again. Baby, 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 oh, baby, yeah, yeah. I love you. I really do.
Has your dad ever heard you sing?
Sometimes. I mean, he's got a recording I did years ago.
I think you've got quite a good voice, Scott.
Amen, thank you.
I mean, this is where this competition for somebody like you is a necessity, because A, you wouldn't get a foot in a record company's door under normal circumstances. And if I'm being honest with you, if you walked into a record company, if you got in, I think they'd throw you out even before you sang. And that's the reality, which is why this show's a good thing.
Okay.
Because I think you've got a good voice.
Amen.
I just don't think you're an American Idol. That's my problem.
Didn't expect to hear a voice like that come out of you, which is always pleasantly surprising.
What did you think, Evel?
They would never see you coming. You know what I'm saying? And I think that that's a beautiful thing. I mean, you know what? So much in this country is based on looks and image and blah, 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 blah. But you know what? I would sure love to give America a chance to decide for themselves with you, because I think you got a lot of talent.
Amen. Thank you.
Okay. LL, yes or no?
Yes.
Paula?
Yes.
Randy?
Yes, dude. You can blow, man.
Thank you.
Very impressive.
Scott, guess what? You've just proved your dad wrong.
Yes.
Welcome to Hollywood, baby. Work it out. Work it out, man. Be proud.
What?
Success and validation. We'll follow Scott's progress in Hollywood.
Right there, right there.
Coming up.
Yes!
It's day 2 of the Cleveland auditions.
Just such a shame it ends today. So much fun.
Yeah.
The morning does not start well. The judges see countless auditions without much success.
15,000 people applied in Cleveland, and yet the odds of you getting through are 1,000,000 to 1. It is hard enough to do well in this industry when you're great. It's almost impossible when you're not very good.
Yeah.
Randy, that's a no?
Oh, definitely.
No. You've got to be amazing. That wasn't. Does anybody want to say yes or no?
I'm going to have to pass.
Dude, you shouldn't ever be singing. It's not for you, man.
Next.
Yeah.
What they wanted was something unique. Jennifer Page thought she had the answer. She just wasn't going to tell them.
She's unique because she's the only mime here. I mean, she has a message. Her message is, this isn't a gimmick. She wants to prove to the world that even mimes can be pop stars. She's a voice for the oppressed mimes of America.
Hi, Jennifer. Let's see, how are we going to work this?
I think it's going to involve a lot of nodding and shaking.
Okay. Are you going to sing a pop song for us? Aerosmith.
Oh, Aerosmith. Aerosmith.
Great.
Is that that song from that movie? Armageddon?
Yeah, it could be Armageddon.
Yeah. Live without you. Okay.
That was good.
I'm not exaggerating. It's actually one of the best we've heard in this competition.
I agree.
Yeah. Her pitch was spot on.
No, but I mean it.
Really good
pitch. I'd rather listen to you than half the people who come in this door today.
Oh, man.
I think she needs a mouth-to-mouth, Simon.
Simon, I think you have to give a mouth-to-mouth.
No,
mouth to mouth. Yeah, yeah.
All right, Jennifer.
That's very cute. Thank you, Jennifer.
You're adorable.
Jennifer, thank you.
People come from all walks of life to audition for American Idol. Now, when we came to Ohio, we expected to see our fair share of small-town singers, but we found one with a big voice. His name, Patrick Norman, a.k.a. Farm Boy.
Ruben, Step Aside, Kelly, Fantasia, Call Me, Clay. It's not gonna be pretty. How y'all doing?
It's going down, Patrick.
Not much. Hey, guys.
Okay, your name is?
Pat Norman.
Tell me something about yourself, Pat Norman.
I work on a farm. I live on a small farm.
Cool.
And I love camping. I love square dancing.
So what are you gonna sing?
I'm gonna sing some Nat King Cole, Smile.
Wow, great.
All right, man.
All right. Smile, though your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by. When you smile through your fear and sorrow, smile and maybe tomorrow, you'll find that life is still worthwhile.
Wow. Mm. You know, man, there's a phrase, man, that I say all the time. Dude, you can blow. You were born to be a singer. That was actually really, really, really good.
Wow.
Dude, you can sing, man.
No doubt.
I was impressed.
Yeah, I felt that in my spirit.
Thank you.
Very nice voice.
I think you're great, man. I think you need to, you know, get all the overalls together, baby, and come to Hollywood. I mean, it's up to, you know, obviously, they gotta bless it, but in my opinion, I think you're ready.
Already blessed it, man. I thought you were brilliant. I thought you were one of the best I've heard in quite a while.
You're coming to Hollywood.
Welcome to Hollywood.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, man. So as Patrick headed back to the farm, the Jackson sisters waited to clear up a difference of opinion.
I'm the next American Idol. No, you're not.
I am. You're not. I am.
I'm the next American Idol.
Me and Leandra has been singing since we was little.
They would have make-believe microphones or whatever, and they sung in the church choir.
Music is very important to my family. But we're like probably like the first ones to ever try to do anything like nationally. I like to crack jokes, sing, act, model. And I'm a real people's person.
Totally opposite from me. I have always dreamed of being a singer and being on stage, but I just need to get over being shy.
I'm a big Simon fan. He's gonna be like,
Simon, he's a knucklehead.
I'm gonna be the next American Idol.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
In first was LaShonda.
You ready to go?
Yes.
All right, what do you sing for us?
Monica, Why I Love You.
Okay, off you go.
Oh, my whole life has been much better than ever before. You got a tender, sweet love. Yes, you do. That awakens me and takes over me whenever we touch. Baby, it's just.
Thank you, sweetheart.
Randy?
I'm gonna say no. I thought that you got a good voice, but I don't think you're quite ready yet. I think you need some more experience doing this, you know what I mean?
Okay, Paula?
Stage presence. Good voice, work on stage presence.
But you got a good voice, though.
Hello?
I mean, that was one of my favorite songs. I enjoyed it. I liked it.
It's a no. Sorry, sweetheart.
Starting.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Hey, keep your head up.
The disappointment was obvious, but her family was there for support. How would all that emotion affect Leandra?
Don't cry.
All right.
Come on in, Leandra. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
What's wrong?
No, my sister didn't make it. Right,
LaShonda.
Yes.
But now it's your turn. Let's go.
Summertime. And the living is easy. Fish are jumping. And the caption is high. and your mama's good looking. So hush, little baby, don't you cry.
Wow.
And I love y'all.
All right, okay, LL, yes or no?
No.
Randy?
It's gonna be a no for me too, dear, but you know what? You really tried hard to do your thing.
You are a total sweetheart, and I think you can come back next season.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Come on, just, you know what, you...
Come on, let's all join us.
Okay, come on, join us.
Things are gonna be all right.
Let's have a group hug.
Come on, we all need one.
We all need a group hug.
You're getting a group sandwich hug.
Simon is a knucklehead.
Holler, sister. As it turns out, neither sister is the American Idol, so at least the arguing can stop. Back there in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, they've got outfits and tributes to artists who have struggled for years to make it in the music industry. Image is everything, and as you can see, David Bowie changed his a few times. But as we found in our audition rooms, looks can be deceptive. Meet Brianna Davis. She certainly had her own sense of style, but how do you think you'd sound if you chose to dress like this?
Brianna, come on in. Bree, how are you?
Bree, look at your skirt. Look at my shoes. They'd match.
I love those shoes.
Wow, I like the hair.
Thanks.
You look very nervous.
Nervous as heck.
You can't be nervous.
Yeah, no, there's no reason.
No, there's no reason.
You know why you're not nervous? Because you got this. You know you got it.
I'm born to sing.
So what are you going to sing?
The Phantom of the Opera.
Go for it.
In sleep he sang to me, in dreams he came, that voice which calls to me and speaks my name. And do I dream again, for never found the phantom.
Wow.
Unbelievable. Man, you have such an amazing instrument.
So did you study opera? What's been going on with you?
I just started taking voice lessons earlier this year, but...
Seriously?
Phantom of the Opera has always been my very favorite song.
I wouldn't even take vocal lessons.
Wow.
I think you have an amazing voice. I think your style is real original. I think it's cool. You know what I'm saying? You look fun.
All right, so what do you guys say?
Well, you know, she's like Sarah Brightman, this girl.
Yeah.
So what do you do with someone like this in the competition?
I have a suggestion. You have a voice that can be, you can adapt your voice to rock and you can do it.
Should we take a vote?
All right, who wants her to go through?
I want her to go through.
I do. Okay, you're through.
You're through to Hollywood.
Yeah, you're through.
Welcome to Hollywood, baby.
A surprising victory for Brie. But it's not just makeup that can disguise talent. Anthony Fedorov looked more like a schoolboy than a pop star, but he had something.
Next moment.
The thing that sets me apart from a lot of other people, when I was little, I couldn't breathe. I had a lot of complications with my health. And to make the long story short, the doctor said that I would probably never speak again. And not only I'm speaking, but I was lucky enough to get a voice, and here I am, I'm singing, so.
Hi. Whoa.
Anthony, what's up, man?
What's going on?
Anatoly.
Anatoly.
Finally. Come in. Watching you guys on TV for so long.
Come in.
How do we pronounce your name?
You can call me Anthony. That's my...
Yeah, Anthony, why are you here?
I'm here to be the next American Idol. I'm here, hopefully, to do my best, and I hope you guys are going to be impressed with what I have to offer.
So you woke up this morning and thought, I am going to sail through this competition because I am what they are looking for.
Yes, sir.
Really?
I'm hoping that.
Yeah?
Yes, sir.
This is your destiny?
Yes, I believe so.
Okay. And what are you going to sing?
Angel by John Sakata.
Okay, off you go.
I carry the future.
future, but I still wanna hold you close. Right now, I need that from you. And baby, I try to forget you, but the light of your eyes still shines. You shine like an angel, spirit that won't let me go.
Paula was just saying she's right, that you remind us of Clay Aitken.
Somebody told me that at work the other day.
Yeah.
And the most amazing thing is a tracheotomy, and doctors told you that you'd never speak again.
Yeah, you know,
and
it was
now
a
singing.
What's that?
Now you're singing.
Yeah, it was a tragedy when I was little, but it's, you know.
You made it through.
Yes, sir.
Brilliant
voice.
Well,
you do remind me a bit of Clay. Okay, LL, yes or no?
Absolutely. I liked the performance. I thought it was slick.
Paula?
I think you're a brilliant vocalist. I can't wait to see you back in Hollywood.
Thank you so much.
I'm going to say yes. You're through to Hollywood.
Welcome to Hollywood, baby.
Well done.
Thanks, guys. I'll see you in Hollywood.
Привет.
There it is. The boy with the miracle voice is going to Hollywood. And so are 31 other contestants from Cleveland. Not done yet.
Yeah! We are in the Sunshine State of Florida. Let's see what the town has to offer in Orlando.
Swamping on an airboat is not the only reason to visit Orlando. Most people come for a vacation, theme parks with their wild animals, and wild rides are the main attraction. Still feeling that. So when we showed up at the Orange County Convention Center, what looked like college kids on vacation, turned out to be 9,000 people all lined up looking for one job. The position of American Idol was still open. Contestants getting set for battle.
All right, I want you to get into the ring, and I want you to get a left right to the head, all right?
An unusually prompt Simon was wired for sound, while Randy and Paula argued over fashion.
Shirt is hot. Look at that shirt.
I'd say it's dogging you out.
From the thousands in Orlando out to meet the judges, Marissa Gans was looking forward to some positive feedback.
I audition a lot, and it's nice to know that finally somebody's actually telling you what it is they like or don't like about you, and you could just go home and work on it.
But will she like what they really have to say?
Hello. How are you?
Good. How you doing?
Excellent.
We're good. Do you know Simon Cowell at all?
Yes, I do.
What do you know about Simon Cowell?
What do I know? I like the fact that you are honest. I like honest people. And whether or not you tell me I suck today, I will still value whatever you have to say.
But, what are you singing?
What am I singing? I'm going to sing White Boys from Hair.
Wow. Yeah. Okay. Go for it.
Well, my brother calls him rubber. Well, am I kind of trouble? Oh, my daddy tells me, girl, no, no. But I say, white boys, go, go, go. Oh, white boys are so lovely, beautiful. And toss you all their curls. Give me a tall, a lean, a sexy, a pretty, a groovy, a juicy white boy. No, white boy.
Wow.
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 I don't know if that's a good or a bad, but okay.
You obviously want to do theater.
That is my background, yes.
As what?
She wants to pursue theater, musical theater.
Based on that evidence, I would do plays.
know what? Honestly, it's all such a blur at this point. It was just so quick, and it was just, I did it, I done it, it's over with. Now I get to go pick out at the buffet, which is great.
Well, not a great start, but it was still early in the day. What we needed was someone with total conviction, and Ashin or Sel certainly had that.
I'm predicting I'm going to blow the judges away with the notes that I can hit. I'm singing Whitney Houston's Greatest Love of All. And even myself, when I hear the sound that comes out of my voice, I wonder if it's coming from somewhere else.
The greatest love of all is easy to achieve. Learning to love yourself, it is the greatest love of all.
Maybe we could use a rocker.
Ouch.
I believe in a thing called love. Just the rhythm of my heart. It's a chance you can make it now. We rock it till the sun goes down. I believe in a thing called love. Ooh.
Wow.
Wow.
Thank you.
Or maybe not. No doubt Orlando needed a kickstart to get going, and Bonzel Solomon was happy to oblige.
Home! Watch out, Simon. I'm the next American Idol.
But could she sing?
Come on in here, girl.
How y'all doing?
You got on your dope shoes, a different one each color.
Couldn't pick which one I want.
You color coordinated it.
Now, that's nice, man. So you worked out the belt with the top. I love this, Paula. All right, so what you gonna sing?
Chain of Fools, Aretha Franklin.
All right, work it out, girl. Work it out.
Every chain has got its weaker link. I might be weak, child. Oh, but I gave you strength. Oh, yeah. Come on. Now you tell me to leave you alone. My father says, come on home. My doctor said, take it easy. Oh, but your loving isn't much too strong. I'm added to you. Chang, chang, chang. Chain of fools.
Okay.
You're good. Okay.
Paula, yes or no?
I love you. You got a great vibe. You have a confidence about yourself that you just know it, and you don't have to brag about it. You got it. I loved you. Yes.
Randy.
I would say 100% yes. You were definitely born to be singing. You can blow. You got it going on, man.
We needed you today.
Yes.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
We really needed you today. It's a yes. Smile. You're through to the
next. Welcome to Hollywood. Yeah, Bonzel, baby V.
You better believe it, honey.
Baby V in the house.
You made our day.
Thank you. Have a nice day. Guess what? I'm going to Hollywood!
Vonzel couldn't wait to tell her father the news. But you'd be surprised how many contestants this season couldn't help faking it.
Make it. I'm just kidding.
Animal parks in Florida, and we saw quite a few creatures that reminded us of the judges. It was easy to spot Randy and Simon, but what about the other one?
Now, we all love Paula. She's sensitive, fragile, like a little kitten, but inside lies the heart of a lion. You know, in that audition room, when she really starts to back you up, she can turn things around. Look what happened when she went into battle for Desmond Meeks.
So far, I've been in Orlando about 4 weeks now, and I think I've pretty much danced all over this city. My friends, they pick on me a lot because I'll just be dancing, and the biggest thing I get teased for, I guess, is just doing pirouettes and stuff like that. As an artist, because I believe that's what I am. I'm an artist. Sometimes I just can't help it. I just cannot help but to dance when I sing, no matter what genre of music I'm doing. If they say yes, which is I'm pretty sure they will, I will dance all the way home.
Hello. Hi.
How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Good, Desmond. How old are you?
21.
What you gonna be singing, Desmond?
I'm gonna be doing a little James Brown for you.
James Brown?
Wow.
Love James Brown.
Wow! I feel good, yeah. I knew that I wouldn't now. Hey, I feel so good, real good. I got you, hey. Oh, I feel nice, like sugar and spice. Oh, I feel so nice. Yes, I do, like sugar and spice. Oh, so nice, real nice. I got you, hey. Oh, watch me now. When I hold you in my arms.
You are I gotta tell you, I'm like, wow. That's great. That was great.
Thank you.
Randy.
It was definitely entertaining, not knowing where you were going and what was happening.
Didn't expect that, wow.
But I think he's meant for something else though, Paula, this guy.
Oh.
I'm not sure he's meant for this.
He's so unique. We don't have anyone like this.
I am not convinced, man.
For me, that whole audition was something I would expect to hear outside Magic Mountain at Disney. I thought it was a stage review.
I cannot believe
so
this.
So for me, Desmond, I'm going to say no.
I feel like quitting this show right now. I really do, because I think he's one of the best singers
we've
had.
It's definitely a no.
I'm devastated right now.
But don't you think you see him on a stage, like he does the dance moves? It's all kind of...
No, Paula, you persuade Randy, because I've said no.
It's all kind of close to, like, you know...
No, because I'll tell you one thing.
Everything about him is like an old school show and review, Simon's right?
He did James Brown, and he did it better than James Brown.
No, he didn't.
I don't know about better.
No, he didn't.
Yes, he did.
Better than James? He didn't even do the splits.
Oh my God, you know what?
That's my point.
I'm not kidding, you know what? We don't have anyone like him. He is
like
worthy.
He
is worthy beyond and above anyone that we've put through today. Anyone.
Well, Paula, I've said no, you've got to persuade Randy.
You, up to Paula. Okay, listen, you really believe in this guy.
Have you ever seen me this upset?
Yes.
you stay out of it.
Because I want to go. I'm not kidding. I am really.
You really believe that this guy can go the distance?
Okay, Paula, yes or no?
Yes.
Paula says yes. What are you talking about?
Okay, it's down to Randy.
You really believe that this guy's that good?
He's talented.
Welcome to Hollywood. Welcome to Hollywood.
You know,
so you got to work so hard.
I kill
dude.
For you right now, and I'm about ready to cry because
so
they weren't going to let you in.
Welcome to Hollywood.
Thank you so much. It was hard. It was hard. I got two no's and a yes, but Paula fought. She fought to tears. Literally.
So Desmond Meeks makes it, thanks to Paula. And despite a slow start, 15 other contestants made it through to Hollywood from Orlando.
Welcome to Hollywood. Yeah.
That is the end of the ride for us here in Florida, but the job is not done yet. Join us tomorrow night as the road ahead leads us to San Francisco, where the talent was crazy and constipated. We found crooners.
In San Francisco.
There I go, there I go, there I go.
Would we find a man in the Bay Area?
I never needed anyone.
Or would the women steal the spotlight?
Oh my God.
Brandy guest judges, JP Molfetta returns, and emotions run higher than ever.
This is turning into American Idol, the nightmare.
Shut up. See you tomorrow night, 8, 7 Central. Seacrest, out.